I was born on the 5th of February, 1921, and the doctor drove 5 miles in his horse and buggy. It was a real warm spell right at that day, otherwise he might have had to have a cutter or a sleigh or something. The war was on. My folks encouraged me to get a job making guns to make some money so I could go to teacher's college, which was called normal school. I started working on the pistol, and then I went from there to working on the Lancaster bomber out in Malton. I used to walk over to the West Toronto station at that time, get on the train, and it took me right to work in Malton to make the Lancaster bomber. We moved to Balding. It was Avenue at that time. It was like country, you know. And we lived in it like pioneers. As we got some money, we did some more to the house. At that time, our street was just a dirt road. My brother-in-law, although he worked for Bell Canada, couldn't get a telephone because there were no lines. And there was no, we had to have an outhouse. Between the neighbors and so on, we finished it right up, and we still live in the house. There was only, I think it was about 5 houses on our street altogether. Spalding just went halfway to the next street, and then it was just a path. It was country, and up to the north there were people with a cow or a horse tied here and there. Go over the railway tracks, there was no bridge with the railway going over. It was country. My children all grew up there, and I now have the 4 children, their husbands and wives, 9 grandchildren, their husbands and wives, and 17 great-grandchildren, so I've populated the world. And I still... De Havilland. In 1956, in May, they hired 12 women to wrap up spare parts in the new plant that had been built in 1954. They had a strike in 55, so they hired 12 women to wrap up the spare parts for the old planes. Otherwise, they didn't hire women after the war. Mostly during the war, they were all women. They were all women, but after the war, they didn't hire women. So, 6 months later, that job was finished. We had made up all the extra parts they needed. So, one woman got to stay. Yours truly. The majority of the people that lived around came originally from Italy, and I still have many Italian neighbors. They're really good neighbors, when I retired from work, I worked for 5 years as an unpaid volunteer in the MPP's office, Anthony Peruzza's office. I notice on my street when I go along now, there's 2 big castles almost on the street where you know, it's amazing. I don't know who lives in them, but compared with my house, my house is just a story and a half, you know. But I do have a 80-foot lot, so that's bigger than a lot of the lots. And when yours truly passes on, I think that some big place will be built there, and the house will be gone. Thank you.